a cracking race on paper where he appears to be up there with the best of his generation. He produced an outstanding piece of work on Tuesday, striding over 800 metres before coming home a tick on 23s for the last 400 metres. Fox Swift worked well this week in her lead up to the Captain Tebe Stakes for the three Yo Fillies. She worked 800 metres in 52.33 and her last 400 metres in 23.48. Each way, she'll be cherry ripe on the day. Big ask for Moat Rose. She worked 800 metres in 54.24 and 24.75 last 400 metres. Keep an eye out for the Mick Price trained Hume, who'll line up in the listed pin win plate, 1,400 metres. Massive rise in class after debut win, however, looks to have a bright future. Works solidly with O Yang Feng over 1,200 metres in the 23rd of January 1982 and last 400 metres in 24.05. Last 200 metres in 11.76. Lone Eagle and Mighty Boss partnered up over 1,000 metres, clocking the 1st of May 1971 and 23.80 last 400 metres. Fiance My Friend accepted for the Sofitel Stakes and for Royal Randwick with trainer Robert Smurden electing to stay at home with a four-yo where he is a live hope. He's looking a treat and went super on Tuesday morning, leading throughout in his trial heat. Spot on. Not a lot between the Caulfield-trained aspirants on Tuesday morning, who'll be looking to add the Let's Elope Stakes to their resume. Swampland wasn't pushed hard. She went 1,000 metres in the 1st of December 1978 and 27.51 last 400 metres. Oregon's Day worked with Princess of Queens over 1,000 metres in the 1st of June 1982 and 11.98 last 200 metres. Flying Jess breezed over 800 metres in 52.0 and 23.97 last 400 metres. Berisha can improve third up in the Sofitel HCP, 1,700 metres. He stuck on well in a hot trial on Tuesday morning, really like the way he went to the line. He's hitting peak fitness and almost ready. He'll start at huge EW odds and represents value, way overs in my opinion. Anis Mirabilis resumes. Went 1,600 metres in even time and is probably looking for much further but can sprint well fresh.